What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So if you hear some explosions in the background, I'm shooting this on the 4th of July, so excuse the fireworks. The whole neighborhood is like going crazy right now, but got my Murica shirt on today. But today we are going to be removing the differential out of the C4 Corvette. So let's go ahead and take a look. So first matter of business we had to do is we had to get the rear exhaust out of the way. So we unbolted that, put that thing over there for safekeeping at the moment. Now let's go ahead and dive in and take a look. So as you guys saw in one of my previous videos, I removed the half shaft. So first matter of business, I believe we need to remove this leaf spring. So we got 4 15 millimeter bolts. Okay, so I've got my leaf spring brackets off the middle. Almost forgot though, we've got the crown nuts right here on both sides holding it on. So we gotta pull that cotter pin, remove that crown nut, and it should drop right out. Okay, leaf spring is out of the way. Now we need to disconnect these suspension arms right here. So we are going to be removing these two bolts right here, and that'll disconnect that whole bracket, and the arm will swing down. We got obviously both sides, so there is a nut on the inside right here, and the bolt will slide out this way. Okay, we've dropped those suspension arms, so next we got to get up in here and disconnect this U-joint right here. And then we have to take out these two bolts right here. There's two nuts on the top of the C-beam right here. So we've got to get a wrench on that and then spin these bolts out, drop them out. U-joints here are exactly the same as the ones on half shaft. There's two bolts right here. Then we got to spin the drive shaft and get the two on the other side. And then, last but not least, we got the bolts in the bat wings, one on each side. We're gonna support this thing with our floor jack, and we're just gonna drop it right out. We may or may not end up having to remove the spare tire carrier. Not really sure yet. Depends on how much clearance we have to move the diff forward out of the C-beam when we drop it, so stay tuned. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the spare tire carrier. It's four bolts holding those brackets on. Okay, so now at this point, I've got the U-joint bolts undone. I've got the two bolts out of the C-beam. The only thing holding the diff in is the two bolts in the bat wings. So I've got the diff supported with my floor jack. A friend of mine is gonna come over with a second floor jack to support the transmission. Because the C-beam is basically held in by the diff, so if you take that out, the C-beam and the transmission are just gonna tip down, and we don't want that, so we gotta support that. So just waiting on him to come over and we can get this thing out of here. Alright, so I don't know if you guys were really able to see what was happening up here, but we supported the transmission with another jack with a little 2x4 on top of it. And as we were pulling the diff out, we had to actually lower the transmission side just a little bit, just to get the bat wings out of the holders, and then we could tip it out of the end of the C channel there and get it out. And then as I pulled the diff out, the drive shaft came with it, even though I had the U-joint disconnected, but no big deal, that was coming out anyways. So there you go. All right, there we go. Got it out, also took the drive shaft out. We're gonna change the U-joints in the drive shaft as well, but holy cow, that thing is dirty. Oh, look at all that dirt. That's crazy. Well, we're gonna clean it up and get to work. Okay, now after a little bit of cleanup, it looks a lot better. A little easier to handle when you got clean parts. So now we need to go ahead and take that front cover off and empty out the fluid. Okay, so we've got 3 15 millimeter bolts to pull this guy off. And then there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 13 millimeter bolts to pull that batwing cover off. And then we can pour the fluid out. And that is what the inside of a Dana 36 rear end looks like. And here's the batwing cover. So we need to clean off all of this sealant material on this side and on that side, and then reapply and then reinstall. So I think that is where we are going to leave off on today's video. So a few more things I have to do with these parts. I am going to be replacing these bushings right here. And then obviously resealing this, getting that back on there. We still need to replace the U-joints in the drive shaft there, get that nice and cleaned up, ready to go, and reassemble. So that is going to do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.